Hey there, Yoyos! Today I have a review of the Halo from c3yo Design. This is the first plastic that I've reviewed, and I'm really glad that I gave it a shot. It's pretty cold out here, and most viewers know at this point that my playing area is outside, and so I thought, well, why don't I go ahead and try a plastic, a high-end plastic, to review, being that it's pretty cold for aluminum. The Halo is made from Delrin, which is an extremely smooth type of plastic, and it's also very dense. The Halo also, it's made on a lathe, and you can tell because it has these, it's almost like record grooves. They're very fine record grooves, and it causes an extremely smooth grinding surface. This yo-yo grinds really well, and it's also got a lot of momentum. It's a fairly heavy yo-yo. I was kind of surprised at the weight when I first looked at the specs. It comes in at 68.7 grams, which is heavy even for an aluminum. But it doesn't feel as heavy as that. It's very light on the string. It's very hoppy. It moves very quickly, and it spins for a long period of time. Let me go ahead and crack this open for you. One of the reasons for the weight, I was a little puzzled at the specs once I got it, not only because it feels lighter than it is, but also because it's a plastic body. One of the things that is pretty masterful, actually, that they did is it's sort of a sum of its parts in terms of weight. You've got a very, very large axle, and also the center track bearing, which is a very heavy bearing. It's got a race inside of it. It's got very thick walls. I've never actually played a center track bearing before, and I enjoyed it, actually. I'll talk about that in a second. It spins really well. The bearing sits on an aluminum hub that goes all the way through, and it's pressed in. One of the things that impressed me about this is this hub design in a plastic yo-yo as compared to, say, the solid spin axle, which I personally haven't tried, but I've seen enough comments about the solid spin axle, about it breaking free from the body, that I was really impressed with how solid this is, and how the reason why is because it's pressed in. You've got a slight divot here that's very smooth that ends at the hub. It's an anodized hub, obviously, and the hub goes all the way through, and that's where the bearing seat is. The bearing sits not in a plastic area, but it sits and it snaps right into the hub. So I was very impressed with that kind of construction. The response is also one of the reasons why I decided to take a look at this company, is because they made the snow tires for the canvas from Caribou Lodge, and I was really impressed with that response. And I figured, well, Caribou Lodge is one of my favorite companies. They make an incredibly high-end product, and if they're going to c3yo for their response, then I figured c3yo is worth a look. And I'm absolutely happy with the quality of this product. The string area has a small amount of space before it hits the response, making it really nice for multiple wraps. It's also got a very wide gap. The gap is 4.5 millimeters, so it's fairly whoa. Everything's planned out here. We're very professional. Nothing ever goes wrong. What was I saying? That's how professional we are. The gap is pretty big. It's a 4.5 millimeter gap. And originally, I thought that I was going to want to use a much thicker string. I tried a few fairly thick strings in it. And I wound up, in the end, choosing the Yo-Yo String Lab Type 1s, which is actually a fairly thin string and breaks in really smooth. I did a small review on String Lab, which I'm actually adding to, now that they're coming out with another product, their Type X, which is a very thick string. So I highly recommend checking out the String Lab review and checking out String Lab's stuff. They are a new company. Matt is a really nice guy, and he makes a very unique product. Right now I'm using Toxic Strings, Growl, the String Lab, and also an old G-string format for all of my throws. I have been using the Yoyo Expert strings, which aren't out yet, but as soon as they come out, I'll be testing some more of those. So, the Halo has a standard butterfly shape. I found that even though it's a plastic yo-yo and it's got a fairly even distribution, you can see here where the walls of the cup area are fairly thick, and then you go pretty gracefully into the hub, which is about the same thickness. Even though that's the case, it's a very steady throw. I've found that even on an off throw, it centers itself really well. I was surprised, being that it's a plastic yo-yo, that I was able to handle string tension really well for longer play, as opposed to having to either stop and unwind the string or do one of the crazy tricks to reduce string tension, which I'm not good enough at yet to not interrupt my play. I just haven't put any time into doing that. I think I'm going to start doing that in my play next, to start really looking at more graceful ways of reducing string tension. But I know a lot of people, when they do develop too much string tension, they do stop and just unravel it. And that's what I've been doing now for quite a long time. And I think it's time for me to take another step. Anyhow, so the cup area, although there's no lip, I found that with a little bit of an angle, it's got a really nice grinding surface. Again, the Delrin is extremely smooth and is a wonderful, wonderful grinding surface. And so if you just get the weight a little bit off to the side, I found there to be absolutely no problem doing rim grinds. Let me go ahead and give you the specs real quick, actually. The Halo comes in at, like I said, a weight of 68.7 grams. The bearing size is C-size center track, like I said, and the diameter is 57.69 millimeters with a width of 42.48 millimeters, and the gap. C3yo lists the gap at 4.5, Yoyo Expert lists it at 4.45. It's a tiny difference. I'm going to assume that C3yo has listed it properly, being they made the yo-yo. But again, it's negligible. I went ahead and did a little experiment with this yo-yo also, which is I often will switch my bearings out to a 10-ball bearing. And, you know, I have to say that because there's so much planning in terms of getting this weight exactly right based on the sum of its parts, the yo-yo felt too light with another bearing. The 10-ball bearing has a thinner wall than the center track, and the 10-ball also uses a leaf race rather than using a brace inside. And it's very obvious. Oh, by the way, I de-shielded this bearing. The bearing comes shielded. I have to say that it really played differently with another bearing, and it just goes another. It's just another happy little thing about the engineering of this yo-yo is they really put consideration into getting the weight right. Based on all of the different parts that they use. Again, like I said, the axle is much longer than any other axle that I've seen. Okay, so, vibe. This yo-yo has no vibe. I found that it's extremely smooth. Even though it's fairly large, and I have really small hands, I found that it moves through chopsticks really well, various chopsticks-based stuff. it swings nicely. It feels very, very substantial on a throw. I didn't find that there was anything that I felt was still, how do I put it? I didn't find that there was anything that this yo-yo was not able to achieve in the same manner as an aluminum yo-yo. So, I would say, oh, and the yo-yo is made in Hong Kong, by the way. Walter's a really nice guy. I emailed with him a little bit, had a couple of questions. I have to say that that if you're looking for a plastic yo-yo at a fairly budget price of $59.99 at Yo-Yo Expert, I can gladly recommend this yo-yo. The right now they have the pink hub in stock, and I'm not sure. I'm gonna assume they're probably gonna be getting some more, but I can't speak for them. However, their Yo-Yo Expert to me is the most consistently stocked yo-yo store, at least from what I've found. Other people might differ, but that's what I found. So if you're thinking about getting a plastic yo-yo, I would highly recommend checking out Delrin. I'm impressed. I've never tried Delrin before. I have plastic yo-yos. This doesn't feel like any of the plastic yo-yos that I've played before, any of the injection molded yo-yos that I've played before. It's not, I wouldn't say, oh, this is a plastic yo-yo. I'd say that this is a Delrin yo-yo, and it's a really well engineered Delrin yo-yo. As far as design is concerned, I also really like the overall visual design. As you guys know, I'm a designer, and I place a lot of emphasis on visual design. I really like how it's so minimal. They have got the hub here with the c3, and on the other side, in a very nice font, they've got the halo. And I just really dig the, you know, I've got some gum of schmutz or something anyway. I really dig the overall design of this, and I like the packaging too. I like when a yo-yo company puts some energy into the packaging. A lot of yo-yo companies don't. I would say probably mainly because yo-yos are bought online and the packaging is secondary. So when someone goes to the extent of making a cool package, I consider that to be part of the yo-yo in a way. It's sort of a freebie. People who design decent packaging for their yo-yos are just giving something to the customer rather than using a packaging that will sell it in a store, like most packaging. That's the reason for it, obviously. So that's about all I have to say. I probably am missing something. I've been playing this yo-yo for about 4 weeks now, pretty constantly, and it's great for cold weather. Definitely, it's nice when you're playing in the cold, and it's also, there's no compromise, none whatsoever. I would not say that this is a lesser yo-yo than an aluminum. So, if you're up for trying something new and you haven't tried Delrin before, absolutely. If you're up for trying a Delrin yo-yo, this is great. I haven't thrown any other ones, but I can absolutely, without reserve, recommend the Halo from c3yo. And finally, I have a brand new high-tech scrolling Chiron. You can find more reviews, maintenance tips, and unboxings at sniffy-yo.com. Sniffy-yo.com. And you can follow Sniffy-Yo at Sniffy-Yo on Twitter. And I've been posting a lot of stuff on Twitter. I'm posting to the today's throw hashtag pretty much once a day, at least, showing what I'm throwing, and I'm enjoying seeing what other people are throwing also. It's a pretty cool little hashtag to follow. And there's George. Hey, George. All right, the c3yo, pleasure to touch and throw. Absolutely beautiful, smooth throw. Thanks.